Hello everyone. Today I'm presenting LiveStream, a high-performance stream processing engine for periodic streams. Modern stream processing engines are extremely hardware inefficient. When we analyze the single machine performance of four state-of-the-art stream processing engines, we find that they are about 1 to 2 orders of magnitude slower compared to corresponding implementations available in numeric libraries. There are three key reasons for this inefficiency. First, modern stream processing engines fail to properly preserve cross-operator locality. They also suffer significantly from runtime memory management overhead. And finally, most stream processing engines follow an eager query execution pattern, and this causes considerable amount of redundant computations during query execution. Therefore, stream processing under hardware-constrained environment is extremely challenging. Physiological data analytics is one such scenario where the data processing needs to be conducted using limited compute power available within hospitals. Hospitals collect large amount of physiological signals like blood pressure, ECG, and EEG, and they are generated periodically at fixed frequencies. LiveStream takes advantage of this periodic nature of the data stream and solve the three key inefficiencies by proposing optimizations like locality tracing, static memory allocation, and targeted query processing. The basis for these three optimizations is what we call linearity property of periodic streams. To explain this, let's take a sample stream processing pipeline as an example. Say we have a 500 Hz signal stream, and we perform a sequence of transformation on top of it, and then finally join it with another 100 Hz signal stream. The linearity property simply states that there is a predictable linear mapping between the events generated in this query. LiveStream uses this property to precisely estimate the end-to-end cache locality of the entire query. For any given sequence of events in the final output stream, LiveStream follows the linear mapping to identify the corresponding parent intervals of events. These intervals precisely capture the end-to-end data locality of the entire query. Next, LiveStream tries to estimate the memory required to store all the intermediate events generated by counting the maximum number of events that can fall into these intervals. LiveStream then pre-allocates the memory required to store this event during query compile time, thus almost entirely eliminating the runtime memory management overhead. Finally, traditional stream processing engines follow an eager query execution pattern. Therefore, when there are discontinuities in the input streams, some of the intermediate events generated might need to be thrown away, rendering any prior computations done on those events completely wasteful. LiveStream solves this problem by using a method called targeted query processing. In this method, LiveStream uses the linearity property at runtime and maps the regions of input stream that are expected to produce events in the final output stream, and then selectively execute the query only on those regions. This allows LiveStreams to minimize the redundant events generated during query execution. We evaluate the performance of LiveStream against two strong baselines. Trill is a state-of-the-art stream processing engine specifically optimized for single machine performance. We also compare LiveStream against hand-tuned implementations available in numeric libraries like SciPy, NumPy, and scikit-learn. We measure both single-thread and multi-core performance of LiveStream and find that LiveStream can perform 7.5 times faster compared to Trill and 3.2 times faster compared to numeric libraries. To conclude, physiological data processing using traditional stream processing engines is extremely hardware inefficient. LiveStream addressed this issue by proposing end-to-end optimizations leveraging periodic nature of physiological data. LiveStream outperforms both state-of-the-art stream processing engines as well as hand-tuned implementations. Finally, LiveStream is currently open source, and the source code is available in the following GitHub link. Thank you for listening to my talk.